going to be great. You have met with many fabulous people and you've given our country in many amazing ways.
Can we work in partners?
Nope.
Can I have some Taylor Swift?
Was she famous in the 20th century?
I don't know.
Duh! The 20th century includes 100 years from 1900 to 2000.
That's right. For homework tonight, Seth will be lucky face of our movie researcher.
I don't have a clue who I'm going to research.
I do. I've been thinking about this all year. I love Barry Manilow. I'm so happy I can find out more about him.
Ooh, oh man, I'm in trouble.
School today, JoJo.
Great, until Mr. Z, you told us about a research project. Ugh.
Oh, yes, I heard about that project from Jennifer's mom. She is so excited and has already been researched. Who are you going to study?
I literally have no idea. I'm not interested in any old fogies.
There are several interesting people you could research. This will be fun.
I can't fall asleep. I still don't know who I'm going to do my research project on.
JoJo, wake up!
Hey, who are you?
I'm the ghost of Fred W. Hill, the man your school is named after. I was superintendent back in the 1950s. Me and Mrs. Worthington had a mobile library so children could have a variety of books to read.
Hi, JoJo. Sorry to provoke you. We are going to introduce you to some famous Americans from the 20th century.
Ouch.
No need to pinch yourself, honey. You're not dreaming.
I must have eaten too much Nutella today.
Come on, JoJo. No time to waste.
We just signed
love those things. Hey, I've always wanted to ask you, how'd you get all those little perforations in the crackers?
What are you talking about?
Oh, Fred, you're such a kidder. Everyone knows Martha Graham, the famous choreographer and dancer.
I don't have time for this.
Did someone say graham crackers?
It's small time.
Where's the fire?
Who's got the marshmallows?
I do.
Did you remember the chocolate?
Got it here, thanks to Milton Hershey.
Yum!
That's how to feel sunshine and roast these days up.
Oh, look, here come a couple of guys who must be brothers. Just look at them. Are you two the Jonas Brothers? Oh, wait, no. Wrong century. The Luden Brothers. Joe, these guys invented cough drops.
Oh, not even close.
We give up. Who are you?
We're the Wright Brothers.
Well, of course you're the Wright Brothers if you're not the Wrong Brothers, but what are your names?
No, really, we're the Wright Brothers.
Don't play games with me, you two. I have two other kids to visit this evening who need help with their reports. And several learning targets to cover. Come on, guys.
But it's true. We are the Wright Brothers.
Started the whole environmental movement.
Hey, I've always wondered, what is Goofy? A dog? A goat? A cow?
Let's consider a more complex question. How can chemical companies sleep at night while dangerous fumes are polluting our air?
Life is full of mysterious questions, Ponderon, but we need to move on here, JoJo.
Hi there, JoJo. Nice to meet you. Martin Luther King Jr. here.
Wow, Dr. King, I read your biography. I think your nonviolent approach to ending segregation was the way to go. You are awesome.
Thanks, JoJo. I'd like to introduce you to one of my favorite heroes.
This brave woman is riding a bus in Montgomery, Alabama on December 5th, 1955. She was sitting in the fifth row of the bus in what was called the colored section. Blacks were not allowed to sit in the front, and they were required by the law to give up their seat to any white person who wanted it.
On that day, I did not give up my seat. I did not move to the back of the bus. I did not accept second-class citizenship.
By that one simple and brave gesture, the civil rights movement had begun. Thank you, Rosa Parks.
Appointment.
Who is it?
Amelia Earhart. Oh, I guess she's a no-show. I'll just check her off the list here. There we go.
Fever, fever, forever.
Justin, be quiet.
Looks like your next appointment is coming along here. I think I see a Roosevelt. Yes, here he is.
World War II. I'm talking a moose, Franklin, a big moose.
I have a presidential memorial in Washington, D.C.
My face is on a mountain in South Dakota.
Rushmore! Rushmore! Rushmore!
Thank you. Mr. Jesus.
Hello. This man is a woman known for her pictures of New Mexican landscapes and especially the ginormous things of flowers. Georgia O'Keefe. Georgia, I'm starved. Want to grab a hand soup after the interview?
Sure, Andy. I love your paintings, Georgia.
I'm thrilled you like my flowers. I paint them large so you have to look at them whether you want to or not.
Turning out the Model T in 93 minutes.
Hit it, fella.
which is a good fight.
Over, under, or through, I say, but never around.
They want to talk to me, you barbarian.
Why do you use this weapon? I'll stuff you and melt you on the living room wall.
Franklin, Teddy, stop that this instant.
Eleanor.
Eleanor Roosevelt, what a wonderful surprise. May I just say how much I've always admired you? Such a tremendous first lady for so many years. Had her own radio show, a newspaper column, always fighting for the underdogs, even House. It's a
thank you. Now what's going on here?
He did it.
They're fighting because they each want to be the focus of my report.
Teddy, listen to me. I'm your favorite niece. And Franklin, darling, we are married for nearly 40 years. I will figure this all out and you will behave.
Yes, Eleanor.
Now let me look at this assignment a bit more closely. Well, it's absolutely clear.
Is it me?
Do you see my name there?
Thank you. study for your report yet?
Yes, I think I did. I chose Cesar Chavez, but thinking of him made me think of the everyday heroes in my